My brothers and sisters, good evening. Today we are going to talk about forgiveness. And as well, we will give some explanation about the sacrament of reconciliation. That sacrament, we can say, it's part of the Lenten season. The Lenten season, since the beginning of Lent on Ash Wednesday, we are called to turn away from sins and believe in the good news of Jesus Christ. In that good news, God doesn't want us to die from our sins, but to turn away from them and be saved. So today's God, I will read for you a passage from Matthew chapter 18, verses 21 through 35, that will give you an idea what forgiveness is all about. Matthew chapter 18, verse 21 through 35. Then Peter approaching asked him, Lord, if my brother sins against me, how often must I forgive him? As many as seven times. Jesus answered, I say to you, not seven times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to settle accounts with his servants. When he began the accounting, a debtor was brought before him who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold along with his wife, his children, and all his property in payment of the debt. At that, the servant fell down, did him homage, and said, Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full. Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go and forgave him the loan. When that servant had left, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him and started to shake him, demanding, Pay back what you owe. Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, Be patient with me, and I will pay you back. But he refused. Instead, he had him put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servants saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed and went to their master and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, You wicked servant, I forgive you your entire debt because you begged me to. Should you not have pity on your fellow servant as I had pity on you? Then, in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers until he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do to you, unless each of you forgives his brother from his heart. That's the gospel of the Lord. My brothers and sisters, as you just heard the gospel from Matthew, we saw Peter thought he was being quite generous. Forgiving someone seven times sure does seem like a lot, doesn't it? The truth is, forgiving repeated offenses goes against our nature. Just look at Jesus' parable of the unmerciful servant. He had just been forgiven a debt he could never repay. And even in the afterglow of such generosity, he couldn't find it if in himself to forgive a fellow servant a mere pretense. Jesus knows our weakness. He is not surprised by all the time we forget what he has done for us and fail to show mercy to others. But he asks us to show mercy anyway. The truth is, mercy doesn't come naturally to us. We have to work at it, just as a small child has to be encouraged over and over again to turn off the light when he leaves a room. We have to keep trying again and again until forgiveness becomes a habit. We know Jesus has given us this commandment, and we even know why we should do it. But that doesn't make it any easier. All we can do is practice. But there is the good news. Practicing mercy will break us in a good way. It will set us free from our habit of holding on to annoyances, hurts, and resentments. The good thing about practicing something is that we get better at it over time. So if you don't feel that emotion of gratitude to the Lord that makes it easier to forgive? Yes, my brothers and sisters, God wants us to forgive one another. And he even taught that in the prayer. He taught us, the Our Father. So that's something very close to the heart of Jesus, to forgive one another. Today, you will have many opportunities to practice forgiveness. Go ahead and we can say, you can go ahead and do it. Don't procrastinate. Forgiveness is the key to be in relationship with our God, with your brothers and sisters. You can make the decision to let go of all the reasons you feel you shouldn't have to forgive. With each step you take, forgiveness will heal both you and the person you forgave. Remember, practice makes perfect. When you practice forgiveness, you will be good at it. Don't be thinking about what will happen. Forgiveness is the key to enter the kingdom of God. Forgiveness is the key to put into practice the disciplines of Lent, the observances of Lenten season. We are called to pray, to fast, to do almsgiving. All three very important for our spiritual journey. And then, when you forgive, you will be able to enter the practicing of the Lenten observances. Yes, my brothers and sisters, we have many people. They have been struggled to forgive. But when the Holy Spirit touched their hearts, they really did a good exercise to forgive people who have been hurting them, people who wronged them. They opened their hearts, but that's possible through the power of the Holy Spirit. An example I can really take is about Herbert Kepler, was the head of the German security forces in Occupy Warm during World War II. In addition to security duties, He oversaw the deportation of thousands of Jews to concentration camps. He was also behind the Adyar massacre, in which 335 Italian men were killed in a reprisal for a resistance bombing that killed 30 German soldiers. But after the war, Kapler was sentenced to life in prison. It was not long before he wrote to ask for a visit from his wartime enemy, a Catholic priest named Hugh O'Flaherty. Monseigneur O'Flaherty had thwarted Kepler time in again forging documents, hiding Jews, and aiding Allied troops, despite the fact that Kepler had put a bounty on his head during the war. O'Flaherty accepted his invitation and visited him regularly. Within just a few short years, Kepler joined the Catholic Church and experienced God's forgiveness for what he had done. Monseigneur O'Flaherty had every right to reject the invitation to visit his former enemy, a man with blood on his hands and who had caused untold pain in Rome. But look what happened. Because he chose mercy, he is a living example that God derives not pleasure from the death of the wicked. We all face the decision to be merciful toward those who have hurt us or wronged someone we know. Our situations probably won't be as dramatic as Monseigneur O'Flaherty, but they will still be challenging for us. But think of what God do when we try to forgive. Think of how people's lives can change because of your decision to extend mercy, especially when it seems that you have every right to turn away, not to forgive. Believe that forgiveness is divine. St. Augustine used to say that. To love is human, to forgive is divine. We need to forgive our brothers and sisters. And the season of Lent is all about that. It's about turning away from sins and believe in the good news of Jesus Christ. May God give you the opportunity to open your hearts and allow forgiveness. And then God will show you how important it is when you are doing almsgiving, fasting, and prayer. All those three connected to forgiveness as well. Because the season of Lent is all about to forgive your brothers and sisters in order for you to enter the 40 days of fasting, of prayer, of almsgiving with our Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, my brothers and sisters, there are a lot of things who can discourage you not to really extend your hand to forgive. You may be having problems, difficulties to forgive your brothers and sisters because what's happening in the world, because of how many so many bad things are happening. Probably you may have a coworker hospitalized after a collision on the highway. A neighbor loses her job. Millions of people go to sleep with no food, no health care, and no home. Thousands of young women are forced into sex slavery. a nation rejects the right of the unborn to live. An entire population suffers under a tyrant's rule. Many things can really close our hearts not to forgive. But you need to know, so much of the suffering in the world seems impossible to overcome. And yet, Scripture tells us to have hope, because what seems impossible to us is possible for God. That's why we are called to forgive as our Heavenly Father is forgiving us. May God bless you and give you His peace that will allow you to forgive those who wrong you, to forgive your enemies, and to bring peace and salvation to your brothers and sisters that need of mercy. May God bless you and give you His peace in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Goodbye. Our next time we will talk about another topic, about the faith, about hope, about charity, etc. But forgiveness is a very important theme for our Lenten season.